The Pine River Walleye Trap has been in existence since 1922. It is just as busy today as it was back then. The trap is usually put in the first week of April each year, but this varies depending on when the ice goes out. As water temperatures reach 40 degrees, walleye swim up the Pine River to spawn on the rocks. Our trap intercepts them on their way upstream. It usually takes 3 days to complete the trap. The trap is completely removed once we are finished. The trap is located just upstream of where the Pine River flows into Upper Whitefish Lake. Here is a look downstream at Whitefish Lake. You can see that it is still covered with ice. It usually remains on the lake throughout the whole operation. Ducks and other waterfowl stop to rest on their journey back to their summer homes. The first thing we do each day is go through the fish we have been holding from previous days. The male walleyes are in one holding pen or crib. Females are in another. The females are checked to see if they're ready to release eggs. We call this ripe. Females that aren't ripe are called green. The process of removing eggs from fish is called stripping.
What we've got in here are the females that haven't been ripe yet, and we go through the crib every day. If a female's ripe, we're going to strip her. If she's not, then we're going to put her in the crib and see if she's ready tomorrow. Sometimes when they come up, it takes them a couple of days to ripen up. It depends a lot on the water temperature. The warmer the water, the quicker they ripen up. So we're holding about 150 females in here right now, and we're going to find out how many of them are ripe and ready to give their eggs. Checking the females here to see if they're ripe. These fish have been in here for, maybe since yesterday. We give a small squeeze on the stomach, and you can see if you look here, the eggs are starting to come out of here, so she's ready to go. We're gonna take her over to the table.
Ripe females are placed in this tank for stripping. The males are placed in this tank. Females are taken from the tank and the eggs are squeezed into a bowl. Each female will have 1 to 2 quarts of eggs. Each quart contains about 120,000 eggs. We usually put the eggs from 2 females in each bowl. Then the sperm from 4 to 6 males is added. The eggs are stirred constantly to ensure sperm reaches each egg. Once we are done with the fish, they are released.
Now, one of the things when these eggs come out of the female, they're made to stick to the rocks, so they're real sticky. And if you just let them sit in the bowl like that, they're going to all get into a big ball. And when they get into the big ball, the ones in the center are going to die. So what we do to keep them from sticking so much is we add well driller's clay, and this actually takes the stickiness off them, because each individual egg has got to be able to float around and have water going around it, because the eggs are just like fish. They get their oxygen out of the water.
The bowls of fertilized eggs are taken back to shore where they are washed and added to the tub. Now that the clay has removed the stickiness, it is washed off so the eggs can breathe. The next step is to empty the trap. These two wings that extend from shore to shore funnel fish that are swimming upstream into our trap. The trap has been set all night long. We will herd the fish to one end with this tamarack pole. Fish are netted out and separated by sex. The largest fish we see are around 12 pounds. Any other fish species, such as white suckers, northern pike, red horse, or whitefish, are released to continue their journey upstream. We will typically handle around 3,000 walleyes each year. Any ripe females are placed in the tank to be stripped.
Doing something. Okay, boys. Night out.
Boys, night out. Here we go. Got him.
Yeah, you got him. Woo! Yeah,
yeah.
Race right here. Oh, couple.
After we are done with the trap, we allow the eggs to harden for a couple hours so they don't break during transportation. Once hardened, the eggs are transferred into milk cans and taken back to the hatchery. These are the same milk cans that were used back in the 1920s. The number of eggs we take varies from year to year, but we usually reach our quota within 2 weeks.